might not have the capital that you think you need to get started buying properties. So the nice thing about creative financing is it's one of the tools that an investor should be familiar with. So, for example, you can go to a seller and have them finance your transaction. So, you know, if someone has equity in their property, they've been a landlord for, 30 years, 40 years, however long. They're accustomed to getting checks in the mail every single month, but they don't want to sell the property, and they also don't want to continue to be a landlord. So a lot of times you can approach these types of real estate owners and let them know that there is a, creative alternative to selling the property. So then, basically you agree on terms and on price, and essentially they become the bank for you. So, one of the things that I do when I'm meeting with a seller is I ask them, what are your plans with this money? Are you just going to put it in your bank account? Are you, going to pay off college debt? Like, what are you going to do? Because then that helps me create, a framework of what's going to be the best deal for this seller. And by using creative financing, a lot of times you can actually pay more for a property. And I'll explain, a scenario where we did that in a little bit. But, you work on the terms with the seller. So, for example, you say, well, I'll buy the property for $100,000 and I'll pay you 5% interest. And, if they have full equity in the property, they can take a first lien position against the property and, write a mortgage through a, title company and everything so that, they're comfortable and it feels legit. Because a lot of times sellers are like, well, I don't know who you are. So if you have an attorney write the mortgage, it makes them feel a little bit more comfortable. Because then they can still get that money every single month. And, by doing that, they still have equity in the property, so they're transferring that to you, but then it gives you the opportunity to get into the real estate with low money down. So if they don't have, that much equity in the property, but say they have 50% equity in the property, what you can do is you can have them seller finance your down payment and then get financing through a bank. So a lot of banks will lend, 75 or 80%. And then you can have the seller take a second mortgage on the property for the remaining 20 or 25%. So again, you're getting into a property with none of your own money initially. So a lot of sellers will want you to have skin in the game. And I just always explain to them, I'm going to be fixing up your property. So that's where my skin in the game is going to come from. I'm going to put money in after we close to make the property nicer, which to a seller, I'm making your property better, so the value is going to go up. So if I default, you're going to get a property that's in better shape than when you sold it to me. So, it's a win-win situation that allows you to get into properties. And we've used this strategy here. I mean, there's a lot of landlords in this area that are tired of being landlords, but they love getting that, money in their mailbox every month. So, it's something that you could go out there and you could start finding deals today for people that want this type of solution.
Who collects rent in that scenario?
So you would, as the new owner. And then you would make your mortgage payment to either directly the seller, or you can make it to a third party transactional company, so like a title company almost. You send them the money and then they cut the check to the seller. So it really just depends. That's one of the things, if they're not comfortable and they feel weird about it, you can have those third party companies handle all of the payments.
I've even done with a third party company collects the rent.
Right.
All the rent to a third party company pays everything. I get a check once a month, he gets a check once a month.
Yep. So it's a great thing,